Welcome to our virtual delivery, and thank you for purchasing a vehicle from Performance Lexus. I'm Jeffrey Bobst.
And I'm Carson Neuheisel, and we are your Lexus Technology and Delivery Specialists.
We'll be going over key features of your vehicle and hope that you find this tutorial helpful. Let's get started.
In this video, we're going to be going over a 2020 GX 460. We're going to start with the exterior and then move into the interior. Purchasing your GX, you'll notice that the driver's and passenger side door handles have little notches. Simply tap the notch to lock your GX and put your hand in the door handle to unlock. To open the back hatch of your GX, you're simply going to press in on the handle located near your license plate and pull to open. To lock and unlock your vehicle, there are two buttons placed under the handle. You can also open up the glass screen above your hatch by pressing the button located right there. To open your fuel door, you're simply going to press a button located on the interior of your vehicle. This will open your fuel door and give you access to your gas cap. We recommend premium fuel for our GXs. Located on your driver's side door panel, you also have the buttons to set your seat position. To do this, you'd simply press set and then hold down number 1 or 2. Headlamp washers, your traction control off button, automatic high beams, steering wheel heat, audio trip, and your view button.
Okay, now we're going to discuss a little bit about our mid-screen, which is right in the center there, our dash, and our steering wheel functions. Over here is for your volume. These are for your up and down through your presets and also scanning through your radio. This is your mode button for AM, FM, satellite, media. Here is your voice command button and your pickup and hang up phone buttons. Over here is your main information display controls, which controls that center screen there. This is the enter button. This is up, down, left, right. Back button to get out of submenus, and this is the home button. Below that is your lane departure alert, and also this is your dynamic radar cruise control. This is the settings for the distance that it'll keep you away from the vehicle in front of you. And here is your cruise control stock. Now we're going to talk about the mid screen, which is your information display, main information display. Again, these buttons control that. This is an enter button, up, down, left, right. Back out of submenus. When we hit the enter button or the home button here, that will bring us to a home page. You can register that to anything you like. This happens to be on the digital speedometer. So notice how it reverts back to outside temperature. Once we start tapping those buttons here on the steering wheel, it's going to bring us back up to our menu items. The first one is I. That means information that's about the vehicle. At the very top is going to be your fuel economy and time in the vehicle and average speed. Then we have our fuel economies here again with average speed that can be reset. You just simply hold the center enter button to reset those. Distance to empty, eco indicator if you'd like to watch that, digital speedometer, time until rest, that's your sway warning alert, and then a blank screen. Now if we go to the right, tire pressures, and also tire angles, so when you are out there off-roading. This is your lane departure alert screen with your dynamic radar cruise control, your messages, and this last part here is how we turn off all those features or turn them on or adjust the sensitivities. Lane departure alert, blind spot monitor, little lights in your mirrors, pre-collision system, always on. The only time we want to turn that off maybe is when we're four-wheeling, but every time you turn the vehicle on and off, it defaults back to on. Parking assist, or the little beeps that you guys hear in the front and back when you're pulling into places. Vehicle settings, just a couple little things in there, not much, primarily just to reset your maintenance stuff. And then meter settings. When you go in here, that's just going to tell you language, units. The little eco light can be turned off that comes on to help you manage your fuel economy. We're going to hit the back button again, and we're going back to our digital speedometer. So to the left here, we have your turn signals. This is where your automatic lights will be turned on and off. Right now it's in the off position, and the hash mark will tell you what position it's in. Right now we're in auto. We're gonna turn these up to turn on your lower driving lamps. Also, there is a button over here that is your automatic high beam button. When we depress this button, it tells us in the center screen to activate high beams, switch your high beams on, which what we do is just push forward, and you'll notice that the icon on the top says that they are on. Over here to the left, we also have your wipers. They're automatic. Just like before, we're gonna go up for mist. We're in the off position now, and this is the auto position. This right here will control the sensitivity of how much water is on your windshield before those wipers will turn on. And then we have our rear wiper right here. Up top here, we have our lights, we have our SOS button, and we also have a handy dandy mirror to look for the folks in the back and also to keep your sunglasses. If you push and hold your safety connect button, that'll call the concierge service for emergencies and roadside assistance, or if you need help with your Enform enrollment process. Also, these are for the lights. They're just simply push, and then you have your controls for your moonroof here, the tilt and the open. This also is your door settings. So if you want the lights to stay off while you open the door, simply put it there. This is for the door, and this turns all the lights in the vehicle on. Okay, in this portion of the video for the GX, I'm gonna show you how to Bluetooth your phone. First thing we're gonna do is open up our phone here. We're gonna go to setup, and we're gonna go to Bluetooth. We're gonna click add, and then we're gonna go to our settings. Android, same thing, go to settings and Bluetooth. We're gonna wait down here for other devices until it says Lexus GX. Click on that. We're also gonna make sure that the PIN is the same. We're gonna allow the contacts to come over. And we are good to go. We're gonna click OK. And last thing we're gonna do, if you'd like to have text messages come up here so that you may see who is texting you, we're going to click on the little blue eye there where it said connected, and we're going to click on show notifications. We're going to make sure that this is turned on. Also, you want to make sure that your notifications are on always, so that when your phone is locked that you are able to get those messages to the vehicle here when your phone's locked. All right, now that we're connected, we're going to go one more step. We're going to click on the phone, and we're gonna click this little message box up at the top there. So we're gonna make sure that all the messaging comes through, so everything is there. Okay, now I'm gonna show you how to use the mobile assistant in the vehicle. With Android phones, it'll be Google. With iPhone, it's Siri. There is a couple buttons over here, the phone buttons, pick up and hang up. To get your mobile assistant, we're gonna push and hold the pick up phone button. The top button here, that's the voice command, it looks like a little face. That's the talk to the vehicle, and we'll go over that here in just a minute. We're gonna do the mobile assistant first. We're gonna push and hold and wait for the beep. What's the forecast today? So you're gonna use your mobile assistant to do anything that you do on your phone. So it's just pushing and holding the pick up phone button. I'll give you an example on a text message. So you can text while you're driving so you don't pick your phone up. I'm gonna push and hold. Text Doug Green up.
What do you want to say?
Hey buddy, miss ya.
Your message to Doug Green up says, hey buddy, miss you. Ready to send it?
Yes.
Okay, it's sent.
Okay, so that was the mobile assistant. You're going to use that to make phone calls, text messages, set reminders. Anything that you can do with Siri, that's how you're going to do it. You can also play your Apple Music or play Spotify. I'll give you an example on that. Play classic rock.
Now playing classic rock radio.
So it just simply opened up my Apple Music. and it's playing. Now, the button that's located above the phone buttons is the voice command button. So use that button for the navigation that's in the vehicle and also to talk to the vehicle to do things such as tune to radio stations or channels on XM. I'll give you an example.
Please say a command.
Tune to 103.5 FM.
Tune to 103.5 FM.
You can also tell the vehicle to set the temperature.
Please say a command.
Temperature 72 degrees.
72 degrees.
There are many more commands, and you can find those in your quick technology guide that is with your manual. To do navigation, same thing. You're going to use the voice command button. We're going to use a city, state, and the address. We don't use zip codes in our systems. It does tend to confuse them. So just remember to use the address with city and state. And I'll give you an example.
Please say a command.
Enter an address.
Enter an address. Please say the full address.
8600 Blue Ash Road, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Eight, six, zero, zero, Blue Ash Road, Cincinnati, Ohio. Is this correct?
Yes.
Yes.
And it will load it right up. Now, we get the question all the time, how do we stop the voice from the system?
Please proceed to the highlighted route, then the route guidance will start.
There are two ways. You can simply say delete destination, or you may go to the destination menu, and at the top it says delete destination. And remember, deleting the destination just deletes it from the queue so that the voice doesn't talk anymore. Anytime that you have to delete something, it was always saved and kept on the previous destinations. Now, while we're in this, notice how a message came through. It was Michelle. So I'm going to use my mobile assistant now, and I'm going to ask the Siri to read my recent text message. Read my recent text message.
Michelle Gourd liked your message. Hope you're having a great day. I'll get back to you as soon as I get off work. Want to reply?
No, thank you.
Okay, that's everything.
So I also could have replied using the mobile assistant. There is the message that pops up. You can read it through the vehicle. You can ignore it, or you could call the person back, as you saw there on the screen. I just prefer to use the mobile assistant to read my recent text messages, so I'm not touching the screen while I'm driving and I have both hands on the wheel. Enform App Suite, that's next. That is the navigation app that's on your phone. So when you get your vehicle, we send you an email to show you what apps are available to you. The GX has the Enform App Suite. All right, now I'm connected. I'm going to disconnect here so that you can see it when you open it up. You just simply sign in with your driver's account. If you don't have one, you can create one. Very easy to do. This is the app itself. And you can just basically type in where you like to go. We're going to go to that 8600 Blue Ash Road. I already had it in here. And we're going to either tap the dot or we're going to tap the list. It's going to bring up the address. We're going to click on it. And at the bottom here, it asks us if we would like to save or remove it. So we're going to click the star to save it, and it's ready to sync with our vehicle on our next drive. Again, if I'd like to remove it, you can just tap the star again to remove it. But this goes straight into your saved destinations, which is on your dashboard here. It's right there. And notice how I have Holtman's Donut Shop. The system that's in the vehicle doesn't know where Holtman's is. It knows major places like Costco, Target, Starbucks, McDonald's. That's why this app comes into play. It's pretty valuable to you as the owner. This finds things through your phone and then also puts them into the system here that's in your vehicle. So we're going to get out of this And if you notice, I disconnected from the vehicle. We're going to, where it says here, reconnect to your vehicle now. I am now connected back in the vehicle. Now, Enform App Suite is located in Info Apps. We're going to tap there, and we're going to tap on Lexus App Suite. This is the screen. It has everything that was on your app on your phone just displayed here. We're going to click on Save Destinations, and we're going to click that off. We're going to notice the Holtman's Donuts there, and so is that 8600 Blue Ash Road. You would just simply tap on either one. You can save up to 10 destinations in this app on your phone. You can call it, or you can throw it on the map. Yeah, it's up to you. Now, when you are in the Enform App Suite here, you can use the destination search here to search for places and enter addresses, just like we did with the native navigation system that's in the vehicle. I always like to use this because it's using my phone. So when you want to search a place or an address, simply go into this App Suite, go to the destination search, and you're going to use that same voice command button to search through your phone.
Say the name, category, or address of a point of interest.
8600 Blue Ash Road, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Please try again.
8600 Blue Ash Road, Cincinnati, Ohio. This also depends on your signal with your phone. That's why it had to try again.
Say the list number of the one you want, or say none of these.
So I'm just going to pick number one, because I can tap it right there.
Showing the results.
And here it is right here. Used my phone. Again, you do have to have a good signal. Notice how it didn't do it the first time, but I can tell I only have two bars here. So I'm going to back out of this, and I'm going to back out again so that we can see this screen here. You've got your saved destinations, which you save on your phone and are available here in the car. iHeartRadio, Slacker Radio is now called LiveX Live. If you open up accounts online, you can link those through your app so that you may listen to them here in the vehicle. Also, you have a fuel guide, sports, stocks, and Yelp. Yelp will find restaurants, entertainment basically for you. Fuel guide will always find fuel that's around you as long as you're connected through the Bluetooth. Notice how we have the prices here also. So it will tell you the prices. And if you don't know where a good where a gas station is, you're out of town, pull this up, simply select the place, and it will throw it on the map, or you can call the place, see if they're open. Let's back out of here one more time. Sports and stocks, again, you can pick your favorite sports teams. You'll have to do that on the app itself on your phone in order for them to display here in the vehicle. I hope that's a nice part of the tutorial here that you will enjoy, and I hope that you will enjoy using the App Suite. I love it. I use it all the time. If you have any other questions with those, obviously you can go to your Lexus driver's account, or you can call us here at the store. Okay, now we're going to go over the screen here and the things that are on the sides of the screen. You've got your audio at the top, your navigation, which is the map, climate control, home page, which is what we are on right now, phone, info apps, setup. The bottom one here is a light that flashes for the alarm so that the crooks know that your alarm's set. We're going to start out here on the home page. You can adjust your home page up in the top corner by tapping here. You can change the layout to a dual or tri-screen. I prefer the tri-screen. And you can also pick what you like to see on there. I happen to prefer the weather. So I'm going to put that up here where the compass is temporarily. And now I have the radio, my average fuel economy, distance to empty, and the weather. When you tap the audio button, we're here at the radio. To set your presets, simply tune to the station you like, which I have 103.5 on here. I like to have that on number one instead of the 92.5. So I'm just going to push and hold until it locks it in there. You're going to do that with all your AM, FM, and satellite. This is a mixed preset. Also, your sound settings are right here. You're going to want to set each particular source. They're all different, so whatever you do on FM is not the same in AM or the XM or even your media or Bluetooth. So you can set those right here just by tapping. Now, we're going to go into the climate. So this is where you're going to control your fan speed in the GX. Auto, best thing to do, obviously. It will control everything based on the outside temperature. This is where you're going to go up and down with the fan speed. Notice how the auto turned off once I did that. Just tip the auto back on. You're good to go. Front defrost, rear defrost. This is the rear controls button so that the passengers in the back can control their own. And this is the outside inside air, which does have an auto feature as well. Your temperatures are here on the side. That is for the climate screen. Now there are a couple extra things here. If you tap the dots here, sub menu. So this is a heated front strip for your wiper blades. And this is a HEPA filter that will increase the filtration for smog, pollen, etc. This runs, I believe, for around 10 minutes, but this is it's an automatic thing also. So if the vehicle detects, you know, like a smelly bus in front of you, this will turn on automatically. So I'll turn those off and back out of here. Okay, so that's your climate. Your navigation, here it is. Pretty simple and self-explanatory. Up here, when you tap the compass, it'll change the views for you. I prefer this one where the vehicle goes straight up. Also here is where you're going to adjust the whether or not you want to see what time it's going to take to get to your destination or the arrival time itself. Inside the desk menu, you can manually type in your addresses, look for points of interest, previous destinations like I told you before. The vehicle will always keep a log of where you went. If you want to delete all those, you just hit delete, select all. And we're going to delete them all so that you have a fresh start with your vehicle. The go home button, you would simply just tap that. You can either speak in your home address or type it in, whatever you like. And these are one, two, up to five different presets for you for places that you regularly visit. And we're going to delete the destination here manually so that we don't hear the voice. All right, so that's the navigation part. We're going to shoot over here to the phone. Pretty basic, pretty simple. Favorites, call history, contacts, dial pad settings. Most of the time you're not going to be in here because you're going to be using your mobile assistant. And back here to info and apps, Lexus App Suite, your fuel consumption, traffic incidents, that's run by Artemis, so it updates constantly. You know, I believe it's every 15 minutes. And then the weather, that's free of charge. You're never going to pay for that. It does have a weather map here at the bottom, which is kind of nice. And we'll also give you the current weather and the forecast. And lastly, down here, the button here is your setup. This is where you're going to do everything to change things, customize things for your vehicle. Notice how there's an arrow, and it goes all the way down here to the end. So that's just a general overview there for you. We just like to go over things that we think are important for you. And if you have any other questions for us, just simply give us a call or check your Lexus driver's account. Thank you for watching our Performance Lexus Virtual Delivery Series. It is our hope that these videos have helped you in your understanding and use of your new Lexus vehicle. On behalf of Performance Lexus, we thank you for allowing us to earn your business. Have a wonderful day.